All right, so we're just gonna go over a few things. One is just gonna be a cutting board. So what I'll do is just wet down a towel, terry cloth, set it here, and then put the cutting board on top. And then this is kind of how I like to set up the cooking station. And these will be kind of the salt and the pepper that we'll use for most of the stuff we'll cook today. This is Morton's black pepper and then crushed red pepper. We're just gonna take some black peppercorns and put them into it's like a coffee grinder or spice grinder. The red pepper, I'm gonna put that in here. This is kind of what we're gonna start with. Then we have some extra virgin olive oil. We're always gonna consider this stuff fair game for everything, so we're not really gonna count those ingredients. So aside from the chicken, we're gonna have four ingredients. Salt-free, chili powder, cilantro, garlic. We're gonna take the zest from the lime. We're not gonna marinate it for any amount of time. We're just gonna coat the chicken and then sear it off, finish it in the oven. What to do with garlic, or what I've found the fastest way, is just take and put it inside of a rag or a cloth. Break it up and that prevents it from flying everywhere. And then from there, you can just kind of spread it out, pick out the big cloves. If you just hit it with your knife, the skin pretty much comes right off, separates easily. Chop the garlic. This helps you a little more control the knife. Just put a couple fingers at the end. Cilantro, I just take and fold it in half, and then again. All right, and then the zest of the limes, that's called the Queasy Pro. That's a zester, a microplane. You could use any of these. This one's my favorite, it gets the deepest. And you could do this with lemon, like ideally, I wouldn't say ideally, but it would bring one more color.
Oh, look at those.
Nice, bro.
Look at those flavor crystals there.
Whoa!
That's zesty.
So now we'll go over to our meat side, keeping everything safe. And we'll cut up these chickens. We want to keep them as dry as we can so that stuff will stick to them. From here, the center, the breast bone is kind of right here. You're going to have to go down one side of it. And that gets you split open like that. I'm going to cut up on either side of the ribs or the neck, like this is the neck.